Cal Curtis, how much niacin is recommended? Does it depend on body weight? Of course, almost everything depends on body weight, but there's some standards around niacin. What most people say is you never get any significant lipid out impact from niacin until you get to 2 grams. So here's 2 or 3 different points around that space. Number one, most people don't even use niacin anymore because of some unfortunate misinterpretations of the science in the past, which we can go into at some point. And I've gone into it. You can look it up on my videos, Ford Brewer, YouTube, the great niacin debate. There's still a lot of people that do use niacin. Niacin is really the only thing that increases HDL, decreases LDL, decreases triglycerides. It has a lot of very positive impacts. For the people that do use it, again, they say you got to get up to 2 grams. And here's why they say that. They're typically watching things like LP little a or some of the other lipids. And by the way, niacin is the only thing that we know of yet that has significant impact on LP little a. Another little bunny trail and comment. We are getting some very, very interesting new information from the new drugs, the new high-tech drugs for LP little a. They're called antisense drugs, and we can talk about those sometime later too. But back to the original question, dosage. Here's the thing. I see plenty of people that get a significant impact on 500 milligrams of niacin per day. Now, there's another reason why I have slightly different twists on that. I also track cardiovascular inflammation. And one of the things that we tend to see is that people will get up to these lower doses, but still significant, 500 milligrams, and they start getting decrease in their inflammation, often when that inflammation is associated with LP little a. So again, I hope that helps. I do advise patients to try to get between 500 and 2,000 milligrams, or 0.5 gram and 2 grams per day. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just going to have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable, and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process, and that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got 2 levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrisk.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859-721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrisk.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.